பஞ்சாயத்தி ராஜ். ஓகே, சாப்டர் நம்பர் 38, 6th எடிஷன் ஆஃப் லக்ஷ்மிகாந்த் இந்தியன் பாலிட்டி. வெரி 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 இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் சாப்டர். த டேர்ம் பஞ்சாயத்தி ராஜ் இன் இண்டியா சிக்னிஃபைஸ் த சிஸ்டம் ஆஃப் ரூரல் லோக்கல் செல்ஃப் கவர்மெண்ட். ஓகே, ஸோ அண்டர்லைன் த வேர்ட் ரூரல் லோக்கல் செல்ஃப் கவர்மெண்ட். ஸோ இட் இஸ் அ ரூரல் கவர்மெண்ட், தட் மீன்ஸ் வில்லேஜ் தட் ஏரியா. ஓகே, இட் இஸ் நாட் அ டவுன், இட் இஸ் நாட் இன் த அர்பன் ஏரியா, இட் இஸ் அ லோக்கல் கவர்மெண்ட் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் அ செல்ஃப் கவர்மெண்ட். ஓகே, இட் ஹேஸ் பீன் எஸ்டாப்ளிஷ்ட் இன் ஆல் த ஸ்டேட்ஸ் ஆஃப் இண்டியா பை த ஆக்ட் ஆஃப் ஸ்டேட் லெஜிஸ்லேச்சர். அண்டர்லைன் த வேர்ட் இட் இஸ் கிரியேட்டட் பை த ஆக்ட் ஆஃப் ஸ்டேட் லெஜிஸ்லேச்சர், ஸ்டேட் அசம்பிளி. ஓகே, இட் ஈவன் தோ த 73rd அமெண்ட்மெண்ட் ஆக்ட் இஸ் பீன் பாஸ்ட் பை த பார்லிமெண்ட், த ஆக்சுவல் இம்ப்ளிமெண்டேஷன் ஆஃப் த பஞ்சாயத்து ராஜ் கம்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த ஸ்டேட் legislature, because the state legislature, the state is list only the Panchayat Raj is coming. Okay, so Panchayat Raj is mentioned in the state list of the 7th schedule. So to build democracy at the grassroots level, so write down the purpose of having the Panchayat Raj is to build a democracy at the grassroots level, at the lowest level of the country. It is entrusted with the rural development. Why we have Panchayat Raj? For the rural development. Underline the word rural development. It was constitutionalized through the 73rd Constitutional Amendment of 1992. Okay, now write down the heading called Evolution of Panchayat Raj. So Evolution of Panchayat Raj, if you look, okay, look at me. The Evolution of Panchayat Raj means, see, Panchayat Raj was existing even before the Britishers came to India. Even during the kingdoms were established under the Chola Kingdom, under the Mauryan Kingdom, we had Panchayat Raj. The local self-government was already existing. Okay, but during the British government, it was totally, you know, coming to halt. Okay, then when the Indian Constitution came into picture, then we had a state government, we had a national government. So Panchayat Raj is totally removed, and there was a lot of problem. In some states it was 4-tier, sometimes states it was 2-tier, so there was no uniformity. The entire Panchayat Raj, write down, the entire Panchayat Raj was at the mercy of the state legislature, okay, or the state government. That is why the central government was very keen in developing this grassroots democracy. So how the evolution of Panchayat Raj happens? The Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. So first committee set up by the government to investigate how to improve the local self-government was Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. In January 1957, the government of India appointed a committee to examine the working of community development program, and this community development program was created in 1952, and in 1957 the committee is set up to look at how this program is working. Okay, and a National Extension Service of 1953, and to suggest measures for better working. The chairman of this committee was Balwant Rai G. Mehta. Please underline the word. Balwant Rai G. Mehta was a chairman of the committee which was looking into the working of what? Community Development Program and the National Extension Service. The committee submitted its report in November 1957. So these dates are important. Okay. 1957 January it is appointed, and 1957 November they are submitting the report. The committee recommended establishment of the scheme of, underline the word, democratic decentralization, which ultimately came to be known as Panchayat Raj. Okay, so what is Panchayat Raj? It is nothing but democratic decentralization. The specific recommendation made by it, okay, I'll give you only key points, just underline that. Okay, first is 3-tier system of Panchayat Raj. What is three-tier system? So one is at the village level, okay, one is at the panchayat, one is at the block level, then above that there is a jila parishad, the district level, and the lowest level will be village panchayat, okay, or village panchayat, the village level. Okay, and in between that you got something called block level. Okay, so village panchayat is sometimes known as gram panchayat. Okay, so gram panchayat, block panchayat, and jila parishad. So this three system is, you know, three tiers, they like panchayat, village panchayat is there, then above that block level is there, about the jila parishad. This three has to be integrated through a indirect election. That's what the first point talks about. Second point, the village panchayat should be constituted with the directly elected representatives. So the lower tier, village panchayat, should be directly elected by the people. Underline the word. So Balwant Rai Mehta Committee recommended for direct election for the village panchayat, whereas the panchayat samiti or the Vijila Parishad. That means the second tier and the third tier should be having an indirect election. Okay. All the planning and developmental activities should be entrusted to these bodies. So all the planning of the village level, okay, should be given to these bodies. Okay. That is third point. Fourth point, the Panchayat Samiti should be the executive body while the Jila Parishad should be advisory. Please underline that. So underline the word executive body and mark that with the, so above that you mark one. Okay, just bring the arrow and put it there in the Panchayat Samiti. Panchayat Samiti, they want to be executive body. So they'll be asking the question like, as per the Balwant Rai Mehta committee, which body was recommended as an executive body? The answer is Panchayat Samiti. Jilla Parishad should be advisory, coordinating and supervisory. The district collector should be the chairman of the Jilla Parishad. So they'll ask you which committee recommended for Jilla district collector to be the chairman of Jilla Parishad. Okay, so this is this committee. There should be a genuine transfer of power and responsibility to these democratic bodies. Okay, so there should be a transfer of power. If you look at the transfer of power, okay, the powers which is mentioned in the write down 11th schedule of the constitution, okay, it has got 29 powers. Are they all these 29 powers you can transfer to the local bodies or this one Panchayati Raj. Adequate resources should be transferred to this body to enable them discharge their functions and fulfill their responsibility. Very important. Financial resources should be there. You can see now there's a fight between center and the state, and that because of COVID the states are not having enough resources, center is not giving resources. So resource or the finance is very important for functioning of the Panchayat. So here there's a transfer of resources, adequate resource to the Panchayat is required. A system should be evolved to affect further devolution of authority in future. So we should think about any future, like how we can improve more. For example, in 1995, look at in the state of Kerala, the total Kerala budget 40% has been given to the villages, because thereby they become empowered, they can decide about schools, sanitations, roads, all this. So we have to give more resource to the villages. So these are the 8 recommendations of the Balwant Rai Mehta committee, and these recommendations were accepted by the government. In fact, to be very specific, write down National Development Council NDC accepted this recommendation in the January 1958. The council did not insist on a single rigid pattern and left it to the states to evolve their own pattern suitable to the local conditions. Okay. So the council means the National Development Council said that each state can decide how they want to modify and they want to implement this. Okay. But the basic principles and the broad fundamentals should be identical throughout the country. Rajasthan was the first, underline that, Rajasthan was the first state to establish Panchayati Raj. Okay. And our Jawaharlal Nehru Prime Minister on this October 2, 1959 inaugurated, underline the word, Nagore district, Rajasthan. Okay. And then followed by Andhra Pradesh, which adopted system in 1959. Question can come, which state established the Panchayati Raj? Okay. Based on the recommendation of Balwant Rai Mehta committee, the answer is Rajasthan. Which district? Nagore district. And October 2, 1959. After Rajasthan, we had Andhra Pradesh also. Following this, it was in 1959, they also followed. Therefore, most of the states adopted the system. Now, since the Balwant Rai Mehta committee said that democratic decentralization will be required, we need to empower the Panchayat Raj, all the states started having their own Panchayat Raj after the recommendation. Though most of the states created Panchayat Raj institution, by mid-1960, there were differences from one state to another with regard to the number of tiers, underline the word, the differences were there in the number of tiers, relative position of Samiti and the Parishad, their tenure, composition, function, finances and so on. Okay. So even though there are the almost every state has established Panchayat Raj, there's a huge difference in the their system. One had a two tier system, one had four tier system, one had a Jilla Parishad as important body, one had a village Panchayat. So there was lot of differences among the Panchayat Raj of different states. Okay. For example, Rajasthan adopted, these are not required, just remember, just for one reading. Okay. Rajasthan adopted three tier system of system, while the Tamil Nadu adopted two-tier system. West Bengal, on the other hand, adopted four-tier system. Further, in Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh pattern, Panchayat Samiti was powerful as block was the unit of planning and development, while Maharashtra and Gujarat pattern, Jilla Parishad was powerful. Okay. So at the end, we are trying to say, even though Balwant Rai Mehta committee recommended and some states followed the Panchayat Raj, there were huge differences. There was no uniformity among the Panchayat Raj in the country. Next is study team and the committees. Since 1960, many study teams, committees and working groups have been appointed to examine the various aspects of functioning of the panchayat system, which are mentioned here. You have to memorize this. Okay, year also you have to remember, and you have to remember the committees also and who was the chairman. So first is 1960. Committee on Rationalization of Panchayati Panchayat Statistics. Okay, so underline the word. I'll give a clue how to remember this. Rational. Okay, R-A. Rationalize. So V R Rao. Okay, understand. So underline the word rationalization. R E S. Okay, so V R Rao. Rao is the answer. Okay, rationalization means which is V R Rao. Then comes 1961 Working Group on Panchayat and Cooperatives. Okay, so Working Group on Panchayat and Cooperative. We have S D Mishra. S D Mishra. Okay, so mixing is there. Okay, Mishra is there, mixing is there. Mixing means cooperation. Okay, like that. So, so you can create your own mnemonics, your own ideas, patterns to remember. So some kind of bit of memory and this are required in preparation. 1961 study team on Panchayat Raj administration. Okay, V. Ishwaran. Panchayat Raj administration, V. Ishwaran. 1962 study team on Nyay Panchayat, G. R. Rajagopal. 1963 study team on position of Gram Sabha in Panchayat Raj movement, R.R. Divakar. Then 1963 study group on budgeting and accounting procedure of Panchayat Raj institution, M. Ramakrishnaya. 1963 study team on Panchayat Raj finances, K. Sandhanam. Then committee on Panchayat Raj election, that is also K. Sandhanam. So the Sandhanam has got two committees. One is in 1963, one is in 1965. 1963 study team on Panchayat Raj finances. 1965 committee on Panchayat Raj election. Okay. 1965 study team on audit and account of Panchayat Raj bodies, R.K. Khanna. R.K. Khanna. 1966 committee on Panchayat Raj training centers, G. Ramachandran. All these are required to be remembered, but don't put too much emphasis. This you study only after studying the features of the Panchayat. That is the most important part of the Panchayat Raj. Okay. Then 1972 working group on formulation of the 5-year plan of community development and Panchayat Raj, N. Ramakrishnaya. I think already we have seen N. Ramakrishnaya. That is M. Ramakrishnaya. This is N. Ramakrishnaya. I don't know whether both are same. Okay. It may be different people. Okay. 1976 committee on community development in Panchayat Raj, Srimati Daya Chaubey. Okay. So these are the committees which has been set up, or you can say study group set up to investigate the working of Panchayat Raj. Okay. Then comes a very important committee. This you have to remember completely. Ashok Mehta Committee. Underline the word Ashok Mehta Committee. In December 1977. The Janata government appointed a committee on the Panchayat Raj institution. So only committee to have a proper name called Panchayat Raj institution is the Ashok Mehta committee. All the other committee will have different names. So this committee is a committee on Panchayat Raj institution under the chairman of Ashok Mehta. It submitted its report in August 1978 and made 132 recommendations to revive and strengthen the declining Panchayat Raj system in the country. It means recommendations. So, what are the recommendations? Okay. So, it is giving 132 recommendations. Underline that again. Okay. So, what they wanted to they revive. So, it is not about creating the Panchayat Raj. Already, Panchayat Raj has been created on the recommendation of Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. So, this is revive and strengthening the declining Panchayat Raj institutions. Okay, so what are the recommendations? Number one, three-tier system of Panchayat Raj. Underline the word three-tier system of Panchayat Raj should be replaced by two-tier system. Okay, that is Jilla Parishad, the district level, and the Mandal Panchayat consisting of group of villages with the total population of 15,000 to 20,000. That you forget, but underline the word or encircle the word called two-tier system. So the Balwant Rai Mehta Committee recommended for three-tier system. It's very clear, right? So now you do a comparative study. Here, the Ashok Mehta Committee is saying that we need a only two-tier system. A district should be the first point of decentralization. Okay. So district should be the first point of decentralization. Then comes Jilla Parishad should be the executive body. Okay. Now you compare what Balwant Rai Mehta Committee said. Okay. So this is very important trick I'm giving. Whenever you are reading, always implement. For example, if you are reading about governor, try to compare with the president. When you're talking about a high court, compare that with the Supreme Court. Like with wherever possible, do a comparative study. You will do a very good mark. Okay. When you're doing so, Jilla Parishad should be executive body and should be made responsible for district level. Okay, then there should be an official participation of political parties. Okay, so Ashok Mehta committee says there should be an official participation of political parties in the panchayat elections. Panchayat Raj institution should be compulsory power of taxation. Underline the word compulsory power of taxation. Okay, in the previous committee we were saying that there should be an adequate resources should be given, but here he is saying there should be a compulsory that they should be able to tax and they should be able to collect the money. There should be a regular social audit. Underline the word social audit. Okay, see, in 1977 he is recommending about social audit. Even now it is not very completely comprehensively happened. Social audit means what? We the people can go on audit. Okay, we can go to district collector, tell me how many benefits have been given, how much money has been given from central government, how much you got. So people can go and ask and they can check the, verify the records. That is known as social audit. Okay, so there should be a regular social audit by a district level agency and by a committee of legislature to check whether the funds allotted to the vulnerable social and economic groups are actually spent on them. This is what known as social audit. So completely answer the sixth point. It is very important you should know what is a social audit. That means you are going and checking whether the adequate the resources which was expected to be given, was it actually given or not. Okay, I repeat that, to check whether the funds allotted for the vulnerable social and economic group are actually spent on them or not. The state government should not supersede the Panchayat Raj institution. In case of imperative supersession, that means supersede means dissolution. Election should be held within 6 months from the date of supersession. Write on that word. So the state should not, the state government normally dissolve the local bodies. Okay, they should not do it. But if at all in some compulsion they are doing it, within 6 months election to be conducted. The Nyay Panchayat encircle, this is also very unique. I have seen this question getting repeated again and again. Which committee recommend for Nyay Panchayat? And the answer is Ashok Mehta committee. Should be kept as a separate body from that of a development panchayat. Should be presided by a qualified judge. Okay. So two words are very important. One is the Nyay Panchayat. The second word is qualified judge. The chief electoral officer of the state, in consultation with the chief election commissioner, should organize and conduct the Panchayat Raj. Okay, so chief electoral officer should be conducting the election. So that means they see the state election commission is coming only later. Okay, but here itself they are saying that chief electoral officer of the state should conduct the election. Development function should be transferred to the Jilla Parishad. Underline the word development function to be transferred to the Jilla Parishad, and all development staff should work under its control and supervision. Clear. The voluntary agency should play an important role in the mobilizing the support of the people for Panchayat Raj. So encircle the word voluntary agency. So these are the keywords. If you want to take the notes, should take this one. Development function, Jilla Parishad. Voluntary agency should be allowed. Political party should be allowed. Nyay Panchayat, just word right, should write the word Nyay Panchayat. Okay, so this is how you have to take the notes if you want to take, otherwise just encircle it and keep it. Okay, then Minister of Panchayat Raj should be appointed in the State Council of Ministers to look after the affairs of the Panchayat Raj. So which committee recommended for the Minister of Panchayat Raj? Ashok Mehta committee. Seats of SCST should be reserved on the basis of population. This is done, this is implemented. Even now, okay, if you go to Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, the seats are 7.5%, 15%. But in the local level for SCST, the seat reservation is based upon their population, that is implemented. A constitutional recognition should be given to the Panchayat Raj. This should be given requisite status and assurance. So if they are asking first committee to ask for constitutional recognition in Panchayat Raj, the answer is Ashok Mehta committee. But later we see L.M. Singhvi committee is also coming. Okay, underline the word. Constitutional status should be given to Panchayat Raj. So there are 14 recommendations. I'll quickly go through it. Okay, just the keyword. First is two-tier system. Okay, second is district should be the first point of decentralization. Third is Jilla Parishad should be the executive body. Fourth point, political party should be allowed. Fifth point, they should have a compulsory power of taxation. Sixth point, social audit. Seventh point, they should not be superseded. If they are superseded, within 6 months election should be conducted. Eighth point, Nyay Panchayat. Ninth point, chief electoral officer should conduct the election. 10th point, developmental function should be given with the Jilla Parishad. 11th point, voluntary agencies are allowed. 12th point, minister should be there for Panchayat Raj. 13th point, SCST reservation based upon the population. And 14th point, constitution recognition. This is how you take a notes. Due to the collapse of Janata government, so 1977, who was in power? Janata Party was in power. They collapsed because there was no majority and they have to collapse. Okay. Before the completion of its term, no action could be taken on the recommendation of Ashok Mehta Committee. So if they are asking why the recommendation of Ashok Mehta Committee was not implemented, the government itself lost their majority and they have to go out of the governance. However, the three states, Karnataka, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, took steps to revitalize the Panchayat Raj, keeping in the view of some of the recommendation of Ashok Mehta Committee. Okay. Now, next point is GVK Rao Committee. Okay. So, we have seen Ashok Mehta Committee, we have seen Balwant Rai Mehta Committee, now it is GVK Rao Committee. The committee to review the existing administrative arrangement for rural development and poverty alleviation program. So the official name of GVK Rao committee is, underline the word, administrative arrangement for the committee to the committee to review the existing administrative arrangement for rural development and poverty alleviation. Okay, the chairman was GVK Rao. Okay, appointed by the planning commission. Okay, underline the word, appointed by Planning Commission in 1985. The committee came to conclusion that the development process was gradually bureaucratized. That means more officials are, more IAS officers are, more state level civil servants are there. Okay, underline the word, according to the committee, the question can come, which committee come to conclusion that the Panchayat Raj is coming under bureaucratization? Okay, and divorced from the Panchayat Raj. Okay, the answer is GVK Rao Committee. This phenomenon of bureaucratization of development administration as against the democratization weakened the Panchayat Raj institutions, resulting in what is aptly called as grass without roots. Okay, underline that. Okay, we have seen grassroot democracy, but this committee is saying that grass is there, but there is no roots. Grass without roots. Hence, the committee made the following recommendation to strengthen them and revitalize the Panchayat Raj institution. Okay, so we are talking about GVK Rao Committee. Okay, 1985, appointed by the Planning Commission. The official name of this committee is the Committee to Review the Existing Administrative Arrangement for Rural Development Poverty Alleviation Program. Okay, what they are saying, the biggest takeaway from this committee's recommendation is they are saying that there are a lot of bureaucratization happening in the Panchayat Raj, more officials are coming, so it is like grass without roots. So what are the recommendation? The district level body, that is Jilla Parishad, should be pivotal importance in the scheme of democratic decentralization. It stated that district is a proper unit for planning and development, and Jilla Parishad should become the principal body of management of all development programs which can be handled at that level. Okay, so all the developmental programs should be given to the Jilla Parishad. Okay, because district is a very important point. That is the first recommendation. Second recommendation, the Panchayat Raj institution at the district and the lower level should be assigned an important role with respect to the planning, implementation and monitoring of rural development program. Okay, so Panchayat Raj institution at the district level, they should be monitoring as well as implementing the planning. Some of the planning functions at the state level should be transferred to the district level. Okay, so state is at the very higher level, no? So if it is given to the district level, then they can do a micromanagement of the activities. Okay, very, very important. Most important in the GVK Rao committee is district development commissioner should be created. Write down, district development commissioner should be created. Okay, and he will be the chief executive officer of the Jilla Parishad, should be given all the charges of development departments at the district level. Okay, so the question can come, which committee recommended for the district development commission? The answer is GVK Rao committee. Okay. Election to the Panchayat Raj should be held regularly. That is very important. Even now, it is not held properly. Okay, 6 months time is there. Very in the fag end, they will start doing it. Okay, so this committee found that the elections are not happening in 11 states. And one of the recommendation among these five is election should be happening in regularly. Okay, so let me go through quickly the 5 points. First point is very important. This one is a Jilla Parishad. Second one is Panchayat Raj institution should be allowed for planning. Okay, monitoring and implementation of the all the development programs. Then third point is there should be a proper decentralization. Functions from the state should be transferred to the district level. Very important is a district development commissioner should be created. Okay. Election to the Panchayat Raj should be held regularly. Thus, the committee in its scheme of decentralization of the field administration assigned a leading role to the Panchayat Raj in the local planning and development. It is this committee that recommendation the G.V.K. Rao committee report differed from the Dantewala committee. So there's another committee called Dantewala committee. So they had both different recommendation. Hanumanth Rao committee, just write down the year. Okay. So 1986 G.V.K. Rao committee, okay, then Dantewala committee in 1978, okay, then Hanumanth Rao committee in 1984. Both these committees suggested that the basic decision plan function should be done at the district level. Hanumanth Rao committee advocated separate district planning body under either district collector or a minister. Okay, so completely encircle that word. The Hanumanth Rao committee advocated separate district planning bodies under either the district collector or the minister. In both the model, the collector should be a significant role. So almost everybody is saying that district collector, that is very important because see, district collector is having a most powerful, you know, apparatus under him. So if you divide him from the district level, so you don't have power. You cannot do all he, anyway, you have to go to the district collector and he has to give instructions, or he will give ideas, or he will give you machineries. Okay. So district collector, write down here, okay, district collector should be the integral part of the Panchayat Raj, because then only the things will be happening very easily, smoothly, because he is chief coordinator of the district. Write down the word. District collector is the chief coordinator of the district. Okay, then in both the models, that the collector should play a significant role in the decentral planning through the committees stated that the Panchayat Raj institution would also be associated in this process. The committee recommended the collector should be the coordinator at the district level, told you on the all the development planning committees. Thus, the Hanumanth Rao differed in this respect from the Balwant Rai Mehta. If this is little confusing, please don't read this. Okay, just directly come to the LM Singhvi committee. Okay, so taking point is this is the only point. Okay, the Hanumanth Rao committee advocated for separate district planning bodies should be district collector. Okay, that's the thing. Then we go for LM Singhvi committee. Okay, now this is a very important committee, because based upon this committee only there is a constitutional status giving to the Panchayat. 1986, underline the word, Rajiv Gandhi government appointed the committee to prepare a concept on revitalization of Panchayat Raj institution for democracy and development. Under the chairman of the LM Singhvi, the following recommendations were there. Okay, so they'll ask you, what is the name of this committee, who appointed this, okay, and when it was appointed. It was appointed in 1986, appointed by the Rajiv Gandhi government, and the official name is Revitalization of Panchayat Raj Institution for the Democracy and Development. So what are the recommendations? The Panchayat Raj institution should be constitutionally recognized, protected and preserved. Very important recommendation. So question will come, on whose recommendation constitutional status was given to the Panchayat Raj? Answer is LM Singhvi committee. For this purpose, a new chapter should be added in the Constitution of India. This will make their identity and integrity reasonable and substantially inviolate. It also suggested constitutional provision to ensure a regular, free and fair election to the Panchayat Raj bodies. So very comprehensive constitutional amendment they wanted, LM Singhvi, and it was done also. Nyay Panchayat should be established as a cluster of villages. Already we have seen Nyay Panchayat was recommended by other committee. The villages should be recognized to make Gram Panchayat more viable. It also emphasized the importance of Gram Sabha and called it as an embodiment of direct democracy. They'll ask you, who said this village Panchayat or Gram Panchayat as an embodiment of direct democracy? The answer is LM Singhvi committee. Underline the word, embodiment of direct democracy. Embodiment of direct democracy. The village Panchayat should have more financial resources. Okay, obviously, the judicial tribunal should be established in each state to adjudicate controversies about the election to the Panchayat Raj. So they said that you should not go to the court. Instead, you create a separate judicial tribunal. Okay, these are the recommendations. So LM Singhvi committee, most important recommendation is constitutional status. Nyay Panchayat should be created. Gram Sabha, they termed as embodiment of direct democracy. Financial resource to be given. Judicial tribunal has to be created. Okay.